this moment, we believe that we have a good chance to get substantial projects. Several business missions planned for the future. We have already been to Korea and China, but we are going to explore new markets, since especially the shipbuilding in Asia is very low now, like Indonesia, of course Cyprus and Croatia, where we hope that soon big new buildings are going to take place. So the Hemexpo companies range from the biggest company in Greece, the Ohalco Group, to very small companies, but with very strong innovation and very specific products that they can offer. So I'm going to just take several seconds to present to you the companies which I'm not going to have a presentation later on. Starting with Captain Nemo, is a company which is manufacturing ladders, rope ladders, and all types of nets. And under development, they have a plan to create a personnel transfer basket. Elbrick is a family-owned company which has been manufacturing panels, ceilings, and doors. And they are now in the process to develop new types of these building materials, which is an excellent solution, especially for bulk area, for deep sea going vessels when they have retrofit problems. ESS is a very promising company that is developing sensors, and we have seen from all the presentations of Olympia Electronics is one of our members from the north of Greece, situated very close to Thessaloniki, a very advanced company for the Greek standards, with 10% of the personnel involved in the R&D for fire detection system and emergency lighting. SRH has it's a very known company for services and support of navigational equipment, and they just introduced their solution IntelliVessel, which aims to facilitate the services for the bridge equipment. Oteco is producing temperature sensors and level switches, but also can give a big range of solutions for automation. And under development, they have the temperature probes with digital protocol output. Valiantis is one of our newest members. They are producing electric motors, brake motors, winch motors, fans, inverters, soft starters. They are developing the new super premium efficiency motors. I will be just one minute. And the competitive advantage is that they have stock points all around the world. And of course, the Biohalco Group is offering a vast range of metal products. Elval with aluminium plates, Sidenor with the hot rolled steel plates and the welding material, and the Hellenic cables with all the range of cables required for a ship. Of course, if we had shipyards in Greece, they could have a much bigger application, but unfortunately we don't. Associate members that offer services related to Hemexpo members, such as design, testing laboratories, ship naval architects, and e-learning. Just to close, our idea is that, as Mr. Hatzigrigori said, we have to work more closely together. We have to find synergies. And we have to find a way to give information to MATECMA members of what we are developing, what is our ideas regarding the products and the services. But also we want to receive from MATECMA. That's very important. We need to know what products, if the products that we are making are good enough, what we should produce more, what we should produce less. We just saw Mr. Hatzigrigoris give us a very good feedback that we should take into consideration and start working more more closely on that. So as specific actions last night we discussed, and we agreed that the Hemexpo companies are now going to participate to the MATECMA meetings and exchange more and more information. First of all, exchange business cards, more and more information. Also, The plan is that the Martecma board and the Himexpo board will be convening at a normal, regular basis, not, don't worry, it's not going to be so much. And also a working group is going to be formed in order to provide the advisory actions. So thank you very much, and I'm looking forward to the rest of the parties.
With the technical support of a German wire rope manufacturer, Kazar, we might all know from the cranes, we established the first production unit of wire ropes. There you can see some stranding and closing of wire ropes back in the early 70s. By 71, the factory was expanded with a new production unit for synthetic rope manufacturing. Ever since, our company has become a world leader in ropes, steel wire ropes, anchor and anchor chain supply. Anchors and anchor chains we do not produce, we only stock them, we stock and supply them to the several industries. We are responding 24/7 to the customers' needs of all over the world throughout 20 stock points that we have globally. Just to mention a few of them, is Singapore, Houston, Los Angeles, New York, Panama, Rotterdam, Dubai, etc., etc. These are some rough drafts of the performance of our company. Okay. So we go to anchor chains, first of all. A few pictures of our backyard, we call them the chain garden. Yes, and anchors, wire ropes. Wire ropes. We have the simple cabled wire ropes, and we also have the special non-rotating crane wire ropes, with or without plastic impregnation. Plastic impregnation is good for sea conditions because it prevents salt crystallization in the center of the rope, where usually the rust starts from. Synthetic ropes. A part of the 3-strand and 8-strand ropes. The company has invented back to the 1996 the famous kappa rope construction. Kappa rope was and still remains the unique round rope construction that is externally spliced as an 8-strand rope rather than a double plate splicing method, where the core and the jacket are individually parted and spliced. This creates the unique advantage, as those ropes are the only round surface ropes suitable for winches that can be operational on drums and re-spliced on board. The last 15 years, we have intensively developed synthetic ropes that can replace wire ropes. But what we mean by that is we have most of the time floating ropes with the same diameter, with the same characteristics as wire ropes. They actually behave like wire ropes. Typical example of that is Capanema and Capanema Plus. We are using top class raw materials.
Very close to the new airport, so if you are flying, you can have your coffee instead of a gin lounge in the aluminum. We have 55 employees, 6 million turnover, 70% of which is coming from exports. I give you a glance of our agent, Network and After Sales. And since Miami exhibition, we also have a presence in Miami and Portland. A reference list includes about 600 new buildings. In 85 shipyards around 21 countries, and ship owners from 25 different countries. Just a list of some recent new buildings. Here is from Arangas. Here is the hospital vessel, which is the first hospital vessel to be ever built in China. And as Eleni mentioned, in Croatia, we have our first project, which is a clipper, the biggest clipper ever. Which regulations, it's under the US mix regulations for cruise vessels sailing in the US. Some awards and certificates, we are certified according to Achilles. This is a special certification required by the offshore industry, especially in the north of Europe. USPH, which is the US safety and public health standards. This all cruise vessels that call US port need to comply to the standards. ISO and SOLAS 2000 and more for some of our items. Our products cover what is under the label of galley and longer equipment. We offer also design services, means that we can make the layout of the galley. And if there are requirements for customized products, we can also fulfill. Some products and services we are developing very fast are solid log putting range. This is a solution that is faster, easier to clean, and much easier to maintain than the normal cooking range with the hot plates. We start producing cooking blocks, seamless cooking blocks, and this is a product that mainly goes to the cruise industry because of this gives us very big specialization and customization in the requirements of the customer. We are also producing a new product we are also developing is hoods with UV system. So behind the filters we have the UV lamps, and this what it does is it reduces, it breaks down the fat. So the fat does not stay in the duct, and the fat in the duct is one of the main reasons we have fire in the galleys. These UV lamps break down the fat and make it just a powder. So the duct stays completely clean.
Ονομάζομαι Θανουριάντης Κώστας και προσωπώ την εταιρεία Fire Architects Agents. Λίγα στοιχεία για την εταιρεία μας, η οποία εδρεύει στον Πειραιά και ιδρύθηκε το 1979 από τον πατέρα μου Δημήτρη, με αντικείμενο το σχεδιασμό και την κατασκευή εναλλακτών θερμότητας, κυρίως για την αφιλία αλλά και την βιομηχανία. Το παρατολόγιο, το ενεργό παρατολόγιο αριθμεί περισσότερους από 400 αφιλιακές εταιρείες, κυρίως στην ελληνική επικράτεια αλλά και στο εξωτερικό, και ταυτόχρονα και πολλά ναυπηγεία, σημαντικά ναυπηγεία της Ευρώπης αλλά και της Ασίας. Επίσης, σταθμή παραγωγής ενέργειας, όπως επίσης δηληστήρια και βιομηχανικές μονάδες. Το σύστημα διασφάλισης ποιότητας το οποίο εφαρμόζουμε, πιστοποιημένο από το Bureau Veritas, σύμφωνα με το ISO 9001-2008, αλλά ταυτόχρονα η εταιρεία μας είναι και approved manufacturer από το DLVGL. Οι βασικές κατηγορίες των προϊόντων που παράγουμε είναι air coolers για τα turbo chargers, τόσο των κύριων μηχανών όσο και των ηλεκτρομηχανών, heaters ατμού αλλά και thermal oil, ηλεκτρικά heaters, marine oil cooling units, steam condensers, ψυγεία νερού και λαδιού και συγκεκριμένες και εξατμιστές φρέων. Αυτή την περίοδο που αρεθνών της εταιρείας μας με λεπτά την πλήρη ανάπτυξη μιας γάμας προϊόντων με κρυογενικά υλικά προκειμένου να εξυπηρετήσουν ανάγκες της συμπλήρωσης ή εξάτμισης LNG.
Projects πάρα πολλά είναι στην Απανατολή. Κατά τη διάρκεια αυτής της διαδικασίας έχεις δει να κάμπτονται κάποιες από τις δυσκολίες που συνήθως βλέπατε πριν 5 ή 10 χρόνια όταν ξεκινήσατε να κάνετε business με τα σερβικά ναυπηγεία. Υπάρχει κάποια εξέλιξη σε αυτό?
Καταρχάς, εμείς διακρίναμε δύο στάδια. Το πρώτο στάδιο είναι μέχρι να φτιάξουμε ένα reference list. Πριν φτιαχτεί ένα έστω και υποτυπώδες reference list από κάποια μεγάλα ονόματα. So, the first thing was to create a reference list. And before creating a reference list and having some big names like Hyundai or Daewoo in that, I can say it was the first stage. We had to buy some projects, as we say, inside the metro at least. The second thing is that after you have the reference list,
you have to establish very well in each local market. And by that I mean it's very important to have a very strong local agent who can help and bring, let's say, the seeker closer to you. We see that when we have projects with some seekers and we have the support from the agent, and we get to know the people working during the project and the purchasing people, the technical people, the design department of the seekers, slowly the seeker becomes more friendly, more open, but this has to be constant.
Thank you.
Thank you very much. Do we have another question? Let me have a last one for Mr. Koronakis. We understood from his presentation, you will have to record your advanced numerical analysis classes because his company does advanced simulation with utilization of boundary, not finite, boundary elements. It's not the same. So he will talk about applications of their code PTIA on cathodic protection, but of course they have done a lot of other applications. Mr. Todd, question, do you have the podium? And allow me to repeat my request for the 10-minute limit.
Καλημέρα κυρίες και κύριοι. Ονομάζομαι Κόκκινος Σωτήρης, εκπροσωπώ την εταιρεία FEAC Engineering. Η FEAC είναι μια εταιρεία μηχανικών που ειδικεύεται στην παλκή υψηλών υπηρεσιών της προσθέτουσας αξίας υπηρεσίας στο κομμάτι της υπολογιστικής προσομοίωσης και R&D μελέτες. Χρησιμοποιούμε είτε εμπορικά λογισμικά για την παλκή των υπηρεσιών, είτε το δικό μας λογισμικό, το οποίο θα σας παρουσιάσουμε σε ένα λεπτό στη συνέχεια. Πρέπει να είμαστε η νεότερη από άποψη δραστηριότητας εταιρεία της Chemexpo. Ιδρυθήκαμε μόλις το 2014, μετράμε λίγο της χρόνια ζωής. Συνεργαζόμαστε με ερευνητικά κέντρα πανεπιστήμια και high-tech εταιρείες σε τομείς όπως είναι οι παραγωγικοί μαγνήτες, η ναυτιλία, οι αναλύσεις μηχανικής ενέργειας, aerospace, automotive, ο ελεγχάς και ούτω καθεξής. Η ομάδα μας αποτελείται από 10 μηχανικούς αυτή τη στιγμή, όλοι με μεταπτυχιακά και διδακτορικά, με μεγάλη εργασιακή εμπειρία στο εξωτερικό και ερευνητικά κέντρα όπως το CERN ή εταιρείες όπως η Rolls-Royce ή Boeing. Συνεργαζόμαστε, όπως σας είπα, με διεθνείς παίκτες. Έχουμε βραβευτεί τόσο διεθνώς όσο και σε εθνικό επίπεδο. Εδώ να πάω σε αυτό το σλάιντ καταρχήν. Διεθνώς έχουμε βραβευτεί λαμβάνοντας το πρώτο βραβείο από την ANSYS για τις υπηρεσίες που προσφέραμε κυρίως για τις ανάγκες του CERN και πιο συγκεκριμένα για τη μελέτη και ανάπτυξη υπεραγωγικών μαγνητών.
Quality checks, which you saw from the Farad presentation, how important they are. These guys at CERN are very lucky because they work under the sound of Cretan Lira, who I know that the founder of the company is an excellent player.
Κύριε Σίγη, καλημέρα. Ευχαριστούμε πολύ που έχει μέσω την Μαρτέκα τη σημερινή μερίδα. Ονομάζομαι Ιωάννη Παρτάκη και είμαι μηχανικό εταιρεία ΣΕΡΜΑ. Η εταιρεία ΣΕΡΜΑ είναι αρκετά γνωστή στην ελληνική καθημερινή αγορά, καθώ και στο εξωτερικό, κυρίω με μηχανικά συστήματα όπω το SES και το Time Driver Working System. Η εταιρεία ΣΕΡΜΑ δημιουργήθηκε πριν από 30 χρόνια, το 1987, από τον κύριο Μανώλη Κλάδο και συνεχίζεται σήμερα από τον κύριο Λευτέρη Κλάδο από το 2000 ως σήμερα. Ο κύριο αντικείμενο και σκοπό τη εταιρεία είναι η ανάπτυξη, κατασκευή και προγραμματισμό προηγμένων συστημάτων αυτοματισμού και ελέγχου για την ναυτιλία. Οι λύσει που παρέχουμε είναι πλήρω εξατομικευμένε στι ανάγκε του πελάτη και του καθεπλοίου, πλήρω αναγνωρισμένε με την εκάστοτε νομοθεσία και type approved από του κύριου μαθητήρια classification societies του IACS. Ειδικά μερικά προϊόντα τη εταιρεία μα είναι το Time Working System, Energy Monitoring Alarm Systems, BNWOS, Cargo Cold Water Emissions Detection System, Atmospheric Oil Emissions Detection System, Wind Recorder και Alarm System, Cargo Oil Tanksman και Manifold Pressure Recorder System, το Seabending Διαχείριση Control System και την νέα εφαρμογή που θα σας παρουσιάσουμε σήμερα, το Continuous Quality Monitoring System. Η Ξέρουμε ότι αυτή την τελευταία δεκαετία είναι πάρα πολύ μεγάλο πελατολόγιο στην Ελλάδα και το εξωτερικό. Συνολικά πάνω από 250 εταιρείες και ναυπηγεία. Το 60% των πελατών της προέρχεται από την ελληνική αγορά και το υπόλοιπο 40% είναι πελάτες του εξωτερικού. Θεωρητικά, περάσουμε στην ελληνική αγορά είναι το Τσάκος Τρουπ, Διάνα Σίπικ, Τεναμάρη, Συγκρίνο Ραβανκάντια και από το εξωτερικό είναι στην Αμπική, στον Άγκρο Ίστερ, Βουάλεμ, Τισίψ, Μάνασεν, Γιάννη. Στην ΑΣΕΛΜΑ έχουμε αναπτύξει ένα μεγάλο δίκτυο συνεργατών σε πάνω από 20 χώρες, όπου παρέχουμε αυτές τις απόρριτες και σέρβις. Επίσης, πολύ σημαντικό στοιχείο είναι ότι η ποιότητα των υλικών που χρησιμοποιούμε είναι γαλλικής προέλευσης και συγκεκριμένα από τη Schneider Electric, όπου όλα τα spare parts είναι διαθέσιμα να βάσει κρίση πάνω από 100 χώρες στον κόσμο. Σύντομα θα σας κάνω μια περιγραφή των κύριων συστημάτων που διαθέτει η εταιρεία μας, ξεκινώντας από το TAM, Level Working System. Το συγκεκριμένο σύστημα είναι ειδικά σχεδιασμένο και για πρωτοποθέτηση σε new building αλλά και σε retrofit. Το συγκριτικό του πλεονέκτημα σχέση με ανταγωνιστικά είναι η πολύ μεγάλη εγγύηση που παρέχουν και αυτό οφείλεται σε δύο παράδοσεις.
The next speaker is Admiral George Christopoulos, coming from a company called Laros. Prisma Electronics. This company is the answer to the EU MRV and the IMO data collection system. Admiral Christopoulos will explain how they can utilize their system for assessing the ship performance. Please.
Thank you, Mr. Rice. Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. It's my honor and my privilege to address such a distinguished audience, having the opportunity to make a short presentation about core performance and efficiency based on big data analytics with Laros technology by Prisma Electronics. Prisma Electronics is a high-tech company established in 1991 in Alexandroupolis, a CERN award-winning company with 25 years of experience in ICT and electronics for defense, space, and industrial hardware and software systems. Prisma employs more than 65 people, 65% of them is of higher education and has established presence in Greece, Middle East, UK and United States. Prisma Electronics team has participated in more than 35 collaborative research projects and the company keeps investing in research and development in the fields of wireless and smart sensor networks, industrial automation and factories of the future, condition-based maintenance, high-dimensional data handling and cloud computing, Internet of Things, and novel detection. Within the engineering framework of Prisma Electronics, we consider ourselves as solution providers with expertise on sensor networks, information system, and data analytics, and this knowledge is encapsulated in the Laros platform, honored with Lloyd's Award for Technical Achievement. Laros establishes automatic data communication infrastructure to collect high-dimensional data on board and to transfer them as actionable information to the shop-based systems. In addition, it's an efficient and comprehensive operative for the maritime transportation that allows the extensive utilization of vast amounts of maritime data being produced on board, transforming them into meaningful information. Prisma Electronics has developed a complete range of smart devices and software tools that enable maritime industry achieve remote monitoring in an easy, deployable and affordable way, providing reliable combined measurements of any point of interest from any seaborne system. Laros system is capable of utilizing any marine grain sensors and measurement devices in order to collect, process and store data locally and then transmit it as information from the collector to the point of interest to a server on board. Subsequently, Laros is using the vessel's legacy system to transmit synchronized information gained to the headquarters of the shipping companies in the most efficient way in terms of cost, speed and security. In this way, the gain from the sensors to the collectors, the deployment effort and the cost of communication are minimized. Laros enables any company to measure, store and process, analyze and view in an efficient way the operation value of the sensors through any internet browser running on board or at the shipping company offices. The collectors include embedded software to the sensor unit digitized, and the routing is performed in an automatic way based on a powerful integrated sensor system. The whole platform consists of a variety of software modules and libraries that enable the operators to customize the operation of the LARO system. It also enables third-party sensors to develop their own software modules for any type of data processing, analysis, and data management. Subsequent to data collection, LARO's data analysis system is the software that enables a new way to look at the high-dimensional data that collapses and condenses the results in an intuitive fashion, but still displays graphs and charts that shipping industry decision makers are accustomed to seeing. This makes analytics and the creation of information intelligence quite easy. Performance monitoring gives you the measures to analyze and to optimize the ship operation by identifying the root cause of any deviations. This is what LARO's platform can offer in an exceptionally efficient manner for ship owners and operators. Aggregations of factual values with sea trials and model test data into performance indicators is a proven approach to performance management as a deviation from the ideal, aging, an abnormal or subnormal operation is crucial for the total system operational predictability and the need for maintenance. Detailed and comprehensive performance monitoring is the most effective method.
Please be seated. The first presentation of the third session will be done by Dr. Pantelis Bakalis, mechanical engineer in the R&D department of a company called Cyclotherm, and has to do with replacements of fluorinated gases, which, as you know, are highly regulated. So, Pantelis, please.
Thank you, Mr. President. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. The presentation involves the new air gas regulations for refrigerants, which, as you already know, has banned several refrigerants till now. Here you can see the contents of the presentation. We will begin with the company profile. We will go to the legislations, to the refrigerants that are banned, to some other directives which are related, and to the suggestions that we will give for the new regulations. And finally, we will present our product range. Here you can see the company profile. Cyclotherm is a company that was founded in 1969, providing services to over 5,000 ships. Today is considered as one of the largest companies in the field of marine refrigeration and air conditioning. It is located in Piraeus. It designs, manufactures, and installs refrigeration and air conditioning units in ships. It also trades spare parts for marine refrigeration units. And the production line is certified with ISO 9001 and 14001. Here in this graph we can see what is the goal of the European Union for in order to reduce the emissions by 30% by 2030, which this also affects the refrigerants, the fluorinated gases. Here we can see that in the last decade the consumption of the fluorinated gases was highly increased, almost doubled. And this is why the European Union decided with the EF gas regulation
4 years ago, taking into account that it's my service at the Paris National Lloyd's Register, my involvement in the new buildings, you know, all these years, more than 37 years, mostly in Paris. And then it was a delegation headed by, at that time, President of Greece, Mr. Markoulias, who visited, you know, Korea, as usual the governments do. And it was a dinner in Seoul, attended by Mrs. Park, which unfortunately now is not anymore, anyway. And was a Korean Civilian Association. And was a speech, you know, by various people. And then Captain Tsakos said that, to make the story brief, the Greek city has been given to Korea more than $80 billion. You must give, you know, at least to Greece, say 10% of this amount, which is a big amount, okay? And then the spirit, you know, came. Mrs. Park automatically called to the president of Korean Civilian Association, the Greek manufacturer, to be included, you know, on the makers list. And then it's happened to be first, at that time, ordered vessels, and we tried to support, you know, the, say, in Mexico, I think, established at that time, or after, I don't remember the other time established, to support, you know, the Greek manufacturers. Taking, considering this, amongst, at that time, was 12 companies, I think, which is most of them just they had the presentations. And we apply products like, you know, apart from for mooring, lights, kitchen, oil water separator, water balance management systems, even you will laugh, but it's true, even mattresses, and we pushed, you know, companies, you know, to get the certificates, because you must know something, that even though we made here so many conversions about the passenger ships and cruiser vessels before, but Mr. Stamoulis maybe will confirm this to me, there is no, this company, they have only mattresses for houses, not for ships. And our ships, you know, and most of us, my friend and staff is not here, come from Korea. And we built ships in Mongolia. This company achieved to obtain a certification, and we use now 18 vessels, mattresses, you know, from the Greek manufacturer. I'm not talking, because my friend Chalapatis is looking to me, we're not talking, you know, to manufacture a main engine, we're talking, you know, for small things, but we create income, you know, for Greece, and particularly, you know, for the medium, say, level manufacturers. Like example, you know, that is Farad at the moment is fighting, you know, one of the biggest, you know, Korean manufacturers, Dongwon, all right? And always, you know, expressed, you know, by the CPRs to use Dongwon or LHC. You know, we use Farad's, you know, products, I could say, over and above. My friend Koronakis, I have heard about Malios, as mentioned, Aluminox. Because you have, you know, I have to say something that 2 weeks ago they came here, the Korean manufacturers, and they invite, you know, the owners to express, you know, comments and how to improve, you know, their services and everything, correct? That is because Korea now has a crisis. I came back last Monday. Today, Stavros went there. And what is the important issue? This reminds me exactly that it's when I was in Korea in the 80s and we started all the equipment coming, you know, from Japan at the time. And still, of course, there is an excuse. The production is in Korea, they had, you know, production, then automatically all developed the industries, I agree. We're not talking to go on this level because we don't have a ship yet. Even we don't have, you know, ship repair facilities. And it's pity to mention that most of the Greek companies at the moment, they docked the vessel, even within this site, or in Portugal and in Spain, or in Turkey and in Varna. In my company this time, in Turkey, has 3 vessels, with 2 are with the Greek flag. This is a shame for me, honestly. Now, but slowly there are, Greece has cannot save the brains in the capabilities to be to assist the industry, sorry, the government, you know, the guns, you know, that manufacturing, you know, things will be exported and everything. Because these people here don't have the support from the government. The interest rates are too high to get loans. We as owners, we have to support them. Subject, I have to put my subjects as well. To gain the name is difficult. Sorry, to gain the name is easy. To maintain, to keep the name is difficult. Seeing this, at the moment the equipment we say we fit it on board, we don't have any issue, any major issue, I would say. But if we go to the international manufacturers, there are more serious issues, even main engineers. Now, it's a... But I think all together, I'm happy to say that now we are 28 companies, if my memory is correct. I think this to be, has to be expanded only for one reason. Coming, the new regulations coming into force, if can be implemented, regarding 05 here, the shipbuilding, I believe personally, will boom again within 2 years. Because the retrofit of scrappers and everything on the ships, you know, say more than 10, 12 years is not worth it. Okay? Because the market is not so good in order to amortize, you know, your investment. They are talking about 3 million or something, you know, the scrapper is not 3 million. You have to consider, you know, the off-hire as well and everything. Okay? Plus, you know, the operation costs in the cattle of various media they use. And I believe that we, Chemexpo, must be expanded. We have orders to support. And we are doing this. And the important thing is that to become a brand name. Not consider Greece, okay, has a problem, you know, crisis and everything, you know, there are poor people, whatever it is. No. Must be to become, you know, strong. And what I believe, that's Vasilis. You must find a representative of Chemexpo in the countries they are building vessels to go around. I know that you have agents, that the agents is looking for the commissions or whatever it is, right? Then that in order to convince, you know, the European Department of the Shipyards, and that one will become, you know, in Korea 1980s we faced the same problems, exactly. Exactly the same, not for the main manufacturers like the Hyundai or whatever. Small factories. Half of them now, of course, sunk down because of the crisis. But this one, that when the market come up, will be there. This is the important issue. And amongst the shipyards in Korea, at the moment, there are the three big shipyards. Even one of the biggest has still problems. Okay? Now, but the market will come up, and we must be there. Then, automatically to become, you know, to the existing fleets. And what I believe there, which I'm going to apply to my company, I will invite, you know, people from Greek manufacturers to stay in our office for 1 or 2 weeks. And I'm going to show to them what orders we have from various parts of the world to compare with this product here in Greece and evaluate, you know, the technical quality, the reliability, and everything. In order to assist, you know, this is because. And the other issue as well we are going to face at the moment that Phelps got not is the after sales. And the after sales, there are people more experienced than me regarding this. Don't think that the sales engineers provided by the major manufacturers are experienced or they are brains or whatever it is, okay? They have a certain training and they face this one. If you ask them the next one, they have a broker. And they charge even, you know, per hour, fares, some of their first class, and so on. The best maker sales I met in my life is coming from a company called Framo, a private company. Right, a 24/7 fantastic service. Unfortunately now has been absorbed by Alfa Laval. Right. Now, it's we have the capabilities, you have the support, I believe. Since now for three years' time, we are from 12 companies, we became 28, something. It's not easy. But you must improve regarding presentation in the shipbuilding factories. Not, I mean, a person to advertise the metrics, not only, you know, that Muri grows. You know what I mean? In general. Unfortunately, this time in Korea is a lot of suffering amongst the personnel of the shipyards. They change in people, correct? Like, for example, the Hyundai have split it on the Hyundai Ocean Services and told the companies, you know, that there's been literally different products. Then you have to. There is another issue I have to mention. When you are working on the new building contracts, like I was 2 weeks ago, the meetings are in Seoul, which is the technical and commercial meetings. The production is down in the shipyards. The procurement guy is not in the shipyard. The procurement guy is down in the shipyards. Right? When you are fixing the contract, I mean, there is a big issue there. I'm trying until now, I believe before I leave this flight, I will achieve it, to sign the makers together with new building contract. This is very serious issues. Because what happened, they are choosing three or four, you know, from your suppliers, and then they play games amongst the four to obtain, you know, the best price. This is the difficult part of the business. Now, it's what you have to do. You started from the marketing of the CBRs, which is based, you know, the commercial department, which is on the headquarters of the company, which they are doing the specification, you know, all the technical requirements, and then you go down to the shipyard, which is, don't forget another one, it's coming my brain. Shipyard is 1 year quarantine, except the LNG, 3 years. The owner is after for a year's having under his feet. This is very important. But sometimes the makers forget about it, and they have the dialogue, you know, with the builders. If you come to the serious components, like main engine, generators, pumps, whatever it is, it's becoming more difficult. More difficult. Unfortunately, you know, production, I could say, but I'm not bothered because it's my heart to make this. The metallurgy has been gone. All the years we have the metallurgy. I don't know if you agree with me. The metallurgy gone. Plus, sorry for my language, there is a lot of monkey as well products. I remember 1.5 months ago, SKF here at the Greece has been scrapped, you know, how many tons, you know, bearings because of the monkey materials, which is that when I read this, honestly, I felt very bad as a leader. Honestly. This one, we must delete all these issues. This, sorry again to say, Jimmy, you're in Greece, the bloody Greek is not, has a roots. This must be deleted. This is important. I'll tell you another to convince you. When you decided to use, you know, products from Greece, okay, we as owner, first of all, we worry about the quality, we worry about the after sales, we worry about the equipment, if it's working or it's going to have, you know, problems in all this. Now we are running 9 vessels, example for the water ballast, HERMA. The reports I have weekly, I don't have any problem. Right? 9 vessels. And they operate in America, Canada, and Baltic, and things like this. Okay? I don't have any problem. And zero. And for my people, you know, on board, I attend all the pilot sea trials of all my vessels that I know with my own eyes. Now the other, I'm looking for Muri, I'm looking for my friend Aluminox, who support the Greek contractor. This is his kitchen. I'm trying to find the equipment on the engine room, to be honest. Like I mentioned before, the bunker meter, this is a headache for the ship owners. It will be more when
the NGO coming to force 05. It's multi business everywhere in the world. There are a lot, even valves, we talk about valves, you produce the production valves. Then maybe you are talking about spares. Is anybody from Kimi here? Kimi. No. Kimi is trying, as old I am, to produce, you know, spares. But they never got the license to the maker. Never. In China, they have licenses around the border. In Korea, I remember the famous fuel pumps, MIN, produced, you know, win-win. All right? Around the corner. Here is other issues which we have to face. But we are here to help, at least I know 10 colleagues of mine, which they believe in Hemexo, and not only on equipment, even on the coming software, it's coming, you know, to design, it's coming on issues like this. And Captain Chakos as well is the leader on this, and followed by other, you know, colleagues of this. And I think we have to assist, and I need personally, I have assistance of a number of people like Stavros as it was, but need a lot of endeavor on these issues. And we have to eliminate things like this. I decided to use one maker, precisely, you know, another makers, they call me, you know, why you use him. Not local, but international makers, right? International makers. Then, automatically it became the bypassing me, they called, you know, Captain Chakos. Why they use him at the end, we believe that Captain Commander to get the permission. This must be, because personally me, I will kick them. I will, honestly, I will bury all of them on the blacklist, straight away. The point here, we are talking for a good equipment, reliable equipment, after sales issues. The price is a different issue. We have experience from a lot of foreigner, whatever you could imagine, from design to equipment. We pay a lot of money and we know what is afterwards. I'm not talking China, real China, China. Now, if you have any, personally I'm happy we're here today. We are 28 commerce. I've seen people like this before, was just, I remember in the Coronation race, 20 people, something like that. And now I've seen what's, which is a good sign. And we only be ready to face the booming of shipbuilding. A lot of ships when I'm there, we're going to be scrapped. If the 05 come into implementation, which I believe will be to 23 instead of 20. It's a big issue there. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Difficult task just before lunch. It's Captain Apostolos Kempes from Arcadia. By the way, good luck to you, your family team, basketball team. And he's going to talk about what is coming, which is the amount versus. He's going to compare the autonomous, as they call it, vessels with the automated. So, Captain, we have the floor.
Mr. Chairman, ladies and gentlemen, good afternoon. On behalf of Arcadia Ship Management and our Managing Director, Captain Dimitrios Matthew, I would like to congratulate the organizers for this event and thank you for the invitation. This being the last presentation, it's going to be light and I hope it will be enjoyable. We're not going to argue here about a technologically advanced product as an autonomous vessel. We're going just to put some thoughts and to see it from the perspective of a seaman, of how can this product fit it into the marine environment. So, in a presentation earlier, we heard that the electronics are taking much of or everything into ships operation and into ships equipment.
It is true, of course, we have been for years now living into this environment. We are functioning into this environment. Some people believe that we have taken the wrong way, that the evolution of humankind goes in the wrong way. I don't believe so. The evolution goes where it will go. We cannot put limits to where the evolution will go. Now, talking first about automation, because an autonomous vessel will be fully automated, we have definition that says that automation is the full or partial replacement of a function previously carried out by human operator. And also again, another definition, the replacement of human functioning by machine functioning. Now, what we don't like as humans is one word of all that, the replacement. We can understand that we cannot feel good about the replacement, but this is where we're going, like it or not. We can put now some levels.
Good evening, everyone. Thank you for being here to listen to us. So, CBI was established in 1982. It's a continuation of my grandfather's company since 1955. With electrical equipment for vessels. It was a general supplier of equipment for vessels. At the moment, we have 15 employees in house and we have more than 20 external partners, which means that they work for parts of our lives. We don't do everything in house, we do the modifications in order to check the quality. We have a lot of molds outside, the components working for us. We have a turnover which is more than 85% coming from abroad. Shipyards, in the bay, FX plants, diamonds, heli plants, the sun has trusted us with projects, a lot of projects. We're also working with a lot of integrators, the biggest one, I think, in the world. We have a lot of companies working with us. I just mentioned some of them. We have after sales presentations in Benelux, Cyprus, Romania, Brazil, Spain, Turkey, now in USA. Last week we sent to USA. Stop points in Rotterdam, Dusseldorf, soon in Singapore, and really soon also in USA. We're certified under Bureau Veritas, RENAR for fire regulations, and we are under ISO 9001. We can provide a lot of lighting features for internal use, external, electrical equipment, and the most important is the new part, the photovoltaic lights, as Mr. DeRoy requested. In 2017, we have the first explosion-proof LED light for marine use, directly for marine use. We have the new LED light, equivalent to fluorescent, for also at its use. And some products for the cruise industry, like downlights. Let's see what can do against our competitors. Our main competitors are in Europe, in China, in Korea, in Europe. Make the SM2 parts. So we have with Glump Shocks from Aqua Signal, which is the biggest player at the moment. We have much better prices, we have for sure delivery time, which can hit them. We are very flexible in custom solutions. We can do anything you need. We can change their lights. We're running a lot of testing in order to make the LED lights more efficient, and we can replace their lights without doing any modifications. I think Bergen Electric, which is the most of you know them very well because you have them in your vessels, have much better quality. The prices are equivalent or better. We have much better delivery time. We're also flexible in solutions like we did with DMSI. We made a production according to Bergen Electric in order to take the project. And our lights are designed for that use. We don't retrofit the lights. We make lights for that use. According to Vista, we produce, where the producers, in this case, buying from others and just renaming them. We have much better prices, better delivery time, and we're also flexible in the solution that we need. According to Chinese manufacturers, that to say, the quality is totally different. The price difference is not so big. We give guarantee and we have options. What we can do for you, for the new buildings? We can provide LED lights in competitive prices, even from Chinese manufacturers. The prices are not very different. For the existing vessels, we to the manufacturing customer level care phase to update the existing housing in LED. All our products are made with European and USMCA raw materials. For the second part, I will make another analyze later. So this is a general description of our lights. It's the classic light, the Poseidon series for us. We use it a lot in all of the questions. This is the LED wave battery. And the Ionian series, which is for internal use. And let's go to some comparisons. We see a fluorescent light 218 watt or 236 watt. The power consumption is 5294 watts, the actual power consumption. The lamp's lifetime is 10,000 hours only for non-manufacturers. And what we can see as problems, we have capacitor failures, we have lamp's lumen reduction very, very quickly, and the lamp holders and relievers are destroyed because of the heat. When we go to the equivalent in the LED, for power consumption, 18 and 34 watt, rated lifetime more than 60,000 hours. I said more than 65 in power consumption. We have at least, say, 6-7 lamps, which is much more, you know it better than me. The human hours are very important to change the lamps. We don't have flames for insufficient light. We don't have problems with fire because the capacitors, there are no capacitors in order to melt. We don't have water ingress. And the temperature is a lot of reduction in the temperature because we don't have losses of the ballast. This is some more technical. What you can understand is the fluorescent light 218 watt has 37.5 lumens per watt, the system. The same in LED is 132. For 236, 51. According the 236 equivalent is 130 almost. Let's go to see about the floodlights. We have lifetime 2,000 hours for hydrogen lamps, 10,000 hours for hydrogen solar. We have the same problems, capacitor failures, lamps failures, and lamp holders can destroy it. The LED equivalent, we have power consumption 50 watt for 500 watt, 100 watt for 1,000 watt, 150 for 500 watt hydrogen solar. Rated lifetime more than 60,000 hours. Here we have a lot of more savings, up to 9%. At least 30 sets of lamps, which is the most important part of this. The human hours are zero. The floodlights are the most difficult part to change. They are in very high spaces. You need ladder to change it, and it takes a lot of time. We don't have fast lanes, and of course, no water ingress. Here you can see what we can change. Now with the LED, we can manipulate the light. It's very easy to manipulate the light and direct exactly where we need it. Also, as common, we have a very good know-how to manipulate the thermal temperature of the LED, which is the main reason for failure. We will see what I was telling you before. This is a solution to update your existing lights. We make the gear tray, as you can see. This is for a diamond light. You keep the housing, you keep everything, and you just replace the gear tray. It is the same procedure as changing the lamps. So this is for a pilot project that we're running. Before we have 4.1 amps, and after 1.2 amps. The lux was 134, was 257. We have 70% almost reduction in the power, and we double the light. And now let's see the retrofit with lamps. It's very easy and quick way to change it. We have tested it. It doesn't meet our standards, and I will explain why. It has approximately 30,000 hours from non-manufacturers again. The total lux is 9,900 lumen and 1,600 lumen. The problems are that the lamp holders are designed for not so heavy lamps, which means that with the vibration that you will have on board, you will destroy it. The plastic LED tubes are destroyed from the heat inside because we close them in watertight lights and cool down. They are made for domestic applications and they have a lot of compression problems. The LED driver installed is very small. If you can see, this is the driver that we use, and that one is a LED driver inside a LED tube, which means that the frequency of the vibration is very low. What that means? That means that we have a flickering that the eye cannot see, but the brain understands it. To summarize that, the temperature of the brain can go up to 2 degrees more than it has been. So it's a very important problem. We don't know it very well yet, but it's in the near future. In very good year, this is what we're doing.
Thank you very much, Panagiotti. And the next speaker represents a high-tech, I would say, company who applies the nanotechnology in various applications. Today's presentation will focus on nanotechnology-based marine coatings. So it will be presented by the founder of the company, Dr. Yannis Arabatzis.
Thank you for your kind introduction. Nanovos is a company that was founded in 2005, having a sole dream to transfer the nanotechnology and the chemical technology achievement into practice and produce, research, formulate and produce coatings that are functional, have some added value to the end user. The company is based in an area of historical significance at Labrio, and one of our core advantages is the focus of on research and the internal development of new products. So there are more than 8 patents and around.
Ψεύτικος, ο ψεύτικος, ο ψεύτικος, ο μόνος.